Good morning. Welcome to worship. We're glad that you are here today. A couple things. First of all, immediately following worship today, we are hoping you can stay for some small group conversations. I have you divided by small groups, and I'm going to assign you, so hopefully you're going to be cooperative and understanding. But trying to mix up families and groups and all of that. So we will be either in the sanctuary, the library, the conference room, or the fellowship hall. And we'll go from there. And then I have the list of questions. They're the ones that are printed in your bulletin. If you need to take a look at those, some people want time to kind of have time to think through them. Very simple things, just asking you some things about just the general understanding and nature of St. James. And really, no more than 45 minutes, so you should be able to stay, grab your coffee, grab some of Miriam's great coffee cake, and head on out to your small groups. So that's immediately following today. Also, Wednesday is both Ash Wednesday, that's here at noon, and then at 1 o'clock is Stitchers for anyone who wants to stay for that group. So hopefully you can stay and be a part of that. Council meets this week as well. Don't forget that. And then also a thank you from Donna Oatman, who's been in the hospital for a couple weeks, 3 weeks or so, and just wanted to send a thank you to everyone who sent cards and well wishes and prayers and all that. She's home. Well, she's with her sister, but she's home, and she's on the road to recovery, so she's very, very thankful for all of our support for her. Also, the information about our noisy offering is in your bulletin. So Dave did a great job explaining some of that last week, that it's a way for us to help folks who are in developing countries with the gift of livestock or a well or all those kinds of things. So if you can feel inclined to give a little extra to the noisy offering, that would be great. We're at least going to do it through February, and we may extend it a little into March. We did it for all of Lent last year, and it was really, really well received.
And last week was a wonderful fountain.
All right. Sounds like last week our donations were great, so thank you for that. Are there any other announcements or prayer concerns that we want to lift up? Okay. That was great. Must have got it all covered. Just a note about our closing hymn today. You're going to need your red hymnal, and it really has more to do with copyright permission than anything. So, other than that, I invite you to stand as you are able for our confession and forgiveness. Blessed be the Holy Trinity, one God, creator of darkness and light, word of truth, wind sweeping over the waters. Amen. Let us confess our sin in the presence of God and of one another. God, our rock and refuge, we pour out our hearts before you. We have known you, but have not always loved you. We have wounded one another and sinned against you. We have not always recognized the Holy Spirit dwelling in each of us. Remember your covenant, renew your creation, restore us, that we might proclaim your good news to all. Amen. The voice of the Lord is upon the waters. God has spoken. The time of grace is now. In Jesus, the reign of God has come near. By the authority of Jesus Christ, your sins are forgiven. You are God's beloved. Amen.
Thank you.
The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, the love of God, and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with you all.
And also with you.
In peace, let us pray to the Lord. Have mercy. For the peace from above and for our salvation, let us pray to the Lord. Lord, have mercy. For the peace of the whole world, for the well-being of the Church of God, and for the unity of all, let us pray. Let us pray. Almighty God, the resplendent light of your truth shines from the mountaintop into our hearts. Transfigure us by your beloved Son and illumine the world with your image through Jesus Christ, our Savior and Lord, who lives and reigns with you and the Holy Spirit, one God, now and forever. Amen. You may be seated.
Our first reading is from the second chapter of 2 Kings. Now when the Lord was about to take Elijah up to heaven by a whirlwind, Elijah and Elisha were on their way from Gilgal. Elijah said to Elisha, "Stay here, for the Lord has sent me as far as Bethel." But Elisha said, "As the Lord lives, and as you yourself live, I will not leave you." So they went down to Bethel. The company of prophets who were in Bethel came out to Elisha and said to him, "Do you know that today the Lord will take your master away from you?" And he said, "Yes, I know. Keep silent." Elijah said to Elisha, "Stay here, for the Lord has sent me to Jericho." But he said, "As the Lord lives and as you yourself live, I will not leave you." So they came to Jericho. The company of prophets who were at Jericho drew near to Elisha and said to him, "Do you know that today the Lord will take your master away from you?" And he answered, "Yes, I know. Be silent." Then Elijah said to him, "Stay here, for the Lord has sent me to Jordan." But he said, "As the Lord lives, and as you yourself live, I will not leave you." So the two of them went on. 50 men of the company of prophets also went and stood at some distance from them as they both were standing by the Jordan. Then Elijah took his mantle and rolled it up and struck the water. The water was parted to the one side and to the other until the two of them crossed on dry ground. When they had crossed, Elijah said to Elisha, "Tell me what I may do for you before I am taken from you." Elisha said, "Please let me inherit a double share of your spirit." He responded, "You have asked a hard thing, yet if you see me as I am being taken from you, it will be granted you. If not, it will not." As they continued walking and talking, a chariot of fire and horses of fire separated the two of them, and Elijah ascended in a whirlwind into heaven. Elisha kept watching and crying out, "Father, Father, the chariots of Israel and his horsemen." But when he could no longer see him, he grasped his own clothes and tore them in two pieces. The word of the Lord. Our psalm today is Psalm 50, and we will read it responsively, beginning with my reading. The Mighty One, God the Lord, has spoken, calling the earth from the rising of the sun to its setting. Out of Zion, perfect in its beauty, God shines forth in glory. Our God will come and will not keep silence, with a consuming flame before and round about a raging storm. God calls the heavens and the earth from above to witness the judgment of the people. Gather before me my loyal followers, those who have made a covenant with me and sealed it with sacrifice. Heavens declare the righteous of cause, for it is God who is judge. Our second reading is from the fourth chapter of 2 Corinthians. Even if our gospel is veiled, it is veiled to those who are perishing. In their case, the God of this world has blinded the minds of the unbelievers to keep them from seeing the light of the gospel of the glory of Christ, who is the image of God. For we do not proclaim ourselves. We proclaim Jesus Christ as Lord and ourselves as your slaves for Jesus' sake. For it is the God who said, "Let light shine out of darkness," who has shone in our hearts to give the light of the knowledge of the glory of God in the face of Jesus Christ. The word of the Lord. Thanks be to God. Please stand for the reading of the gospel.
O Lord, to whom shall we go? You have the words of eternal.
The Holy Gospel according to Mark. Glory to you, O Lord. 6 days later, Jesus took with him Peter and James and John and led them up a high mountain apart by themselves. And he was transfigured before them, and his clothes became dazzling white, such as no one on earth could bleach them. And there appeared to them Elijah with Moses, who were talking with Jesus. Then Peter said to Jesus, "Rabbi, it is good for us to be here. Let us make three dwellings, one for you, one for Moses, and one for Elijah." He did not know what to say, for they were terrified. Then a cloud overshadowed them, and from their cloud there came a voice. "This is my son, the beloved. Listen to him." Suddenly, when they looked around, they saw no one with them anymore, but only Jesus. As they were coming down the mountain, he ordered them to tell no one about what they had seen until after the Son of Man had risen from the dead. The Gospel of the Lord. Praise to you, O Christ. You may be seated.
Shine with unborrowed light.
Grace and peace to you from God our Father and Lord and Savior, Jesus the Christ. Amen. God's presence changes us. God showing up in our lives. God moving in our time together. Whether it is here with us now in this place, here in the spaces we gather online, at our homes, in our Bible studies, in our other gatherings, in our service, God's presence changes us. Just as God changed those that we meet in our scriptures today, God's presence changes the people with whom God encounters. God changes us. In our first reading, we're coming in at the very end of this relationship with Elijah and Elisha. Elisha has been kind of the student, learning from the master, following Elijah, watching and experiencing as he has performed his miracles, as Elijah has found ways to pass on all that he has done because he's completed his time of service with God. But God has let Elijah know that he will not see death before he becomes a part of God's glory. And in the midst of their journeys, he begs Elisha to wait, to stay back so that he wouldn't be upset or to be scared about the way that Elijah is taken from the earth. But Elisha says over and over again, I will not leave you. And even though the various prophets and the company of prophets come out and try to warn Elisha, do you know your master is going to be taken from you? Elisha keeps saying, shh, I know. Just go over there and be quiet. I've got this. And what's interesting about this whole exchange about Elijah, where he chooses to leave, where he chooses to end his life on earth, it's that same location where Moses and the Israelites crossed in that same region as they were entering into the promised land. Now, it's information I didn't know until recently as well, but Elijah and Elisha, they cross over the Jordan. And in that same way that Moses and the Israelites crossed the Red Sea, that God parted the waters, Elijah takes off his cloak, his mantle, and he strikes the water so that it parts, so that he can cross back over into that same area where Moses, where his life ended. Now, if you know the story of the Israelites and Moses, you know that Moses angered God at one point, and God told Moses, sorry, the Israelites will make it to the promised land, but you're going to have to stay behind. You will stay back in this edge of the wilderness. They're going to go on ahead with Joshua. So Moses stays behind, but that's the same place that Elijah chooses to go. That same area where God comes in that whirlwind of chariots and horses of fire and draws Elijah up to heaven. And in the part of the story we don't get to hear just after this reading, as Elisha is calling up and yelling into heaven, Father, Father, Elisha then takes that same mantle, that same cloak that Elijah was wearing, and he takes it and puts it on himself. Both that literal and figurative example of the spirit of Elijah filling him. But he also then goes and strikes the water of the Jordan and it parts. And he then goes on to this land that has been known as the promised land for those Israelites, for all those descendants who have followed from that first group with Moses. And the people around Elisha recognize that spirit of the Lord has rested upon him, and that Elisha now carries it. They recognize what we hear today, that God's presence changes us. It changed Elisha. It changed him to then empower him to go and continue that ministry, to go and continue what Elijah had done in the name of the Lord. Just as Joshua took over from Moses and kept leading the people, their ancestors, Elisha now leads the people. God's presence changes us. Both were changed in that moment. In that same way that we hear in our gospel story today, as Jesus takes Andrew doesn't get to go, Peter and James and John, as they went up the mountain, as they see Jesus transfigured before them in this dazzling white, as they see his presence changed, they are changed. They are changed in that moment. Now, of course, we hear Peter kind of fumble around looking for something to say or do, which we can understand. If that happened to us, we probably would be stunned as well. We wouldn't know what to say or do. And Peter's like, let's build a tent. Let's build a place. Let's stay here. This is incredible. And God in that moment just says, Peter, I've got this. This is Jesus. This is my beloved. Just as they saw in his baptism, this is my beloved son. Now listen to him. Listen to what he says. Listen to what he's teaching you. Listen to everything that he is bringing in my name. And they go down the mountain, and Peter and James and John again are just trying to figure out what this all means, trying to figure out what this will be, but ultimately knowing that it's just going to be about listening and following Jesus. And in the years that followed, as they thought back, this is what guided them. Listen to Jesus. They were changed in that moment, changed as well to continue to follow Jesus, to continue that ministry that he began. They were empowered in their lives of faith. Just as we have been empowered in that same ministry that we continue, as we live out what God has done in Jesus, as we live out those examples of those early disciples in the early church, just as they were changed by God's love and mercy and grace, so are we. We are changed in our times together. We are changed as we gather around this table, as we receive this gift of forgiveness, this body and blood of Jesus Christ. Whether we receive it here in this place or at home, we are changed by that gift of God. We are forgiven and redeemed and healed. Freed from those things that bind us, freed from those things that hold us back from God. We are changed in our gatherings, changed as we serve in his name, as we serve our neighbors, changed as we gather around word and we study his scriptures, as we learn more about what God is saying to us here in this time and place. We are changed. We are empowered. We are sent into the world, changed for the sake of the world, changed like Peter and James and John and Elijah and Elisha, changed to be God's servants in the world, changed to listen still for Jesus, to listen and follow, to listen for his voice as we discern together how best to be the people of God in this place. We are changed by God's presence because God's power, God's glory, God's forgiveness, God's love, God's mercy, God's grace, it fills us that we might go into this world and share it with others. God's presence changed them, and God's presence changes us. Thanks be to God. Amen. So I had a feeling this was going to be a little short, and Tanea's back in the Sunday school with the kids, so we're just going to kind of sit for a few minutes and figure something else out. So here she comes. Sorry. It's great that she can go back and do music with the kids, so we'll just keep talking. This would be a great time. So a couple of our congregational members, our council president, is in Florida with some friends. And Kay, who also is a member here, they're in Florida. So I'm going to invite everybody to turn to the camera and wave to Dottie and Kay and anybody else. And my mom, who watches, and my stepdad, Ro. So, yes, I know, we feel like goofballs. So there, Dottie, we love you. We miss you. Fill the time. Please join with me in our hymn today.
Oh, are we there?
Sorry. Yeah, we were.
I had to explain the ascension to the girls. And I was like, I had to use the reading. Sorry, it took
longer. It's okay. I said, this is what happens sometimes. My sermon was a little short, and sometimes Tanea is back with the Sunday school kids.
Stand as you are able as we profess our faith with the Nicene Creed. We, beloved in one God, the Father, the Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, of all that is seen and unseen, we believe in one Lord, Jesus Christ, the only Son of God, eternally begotten of the Father, God from God, light from light, true God from true God, begotten, not made, of one being with the Father. Through him all things were made. For us and for our salvation, he came down from heaven, was incarnate of the Holy Spirit and the Virgin Mary, and became truly human. For our sake, he was crucified under Pontius Pilate. He suffered death and was buried. On the third day, he rose again in accordance with the scriptures. He ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again in glory to judge the living and the dead, and his kingdom will have no end. We believe in the Holy Spirit, the Lord, the giver of life, who proceeds from the Father and the Son, who with the Father and the Son is worshiped and glorified, who has spoken through the prophets. We believe in one holy Catholic and apostolic church. We acknowledge one baptism for the forgiveness of sins. We look for the resurrection of the dead and the life of the world to come. Amen. We continue with our prayers of intercession. As we celebrate Christ embodied in human form, we pray for God's blessing on the church, the world, and all creation. We pray for the church that the transformational power of God enters the hearts of all people. May its leaders serve as examples of your grace and healing across time and space. God of grace, receive our prayer. We pray for the creation that we will humbly observe the swirl of wind and the heat of the bright sun. Teach us to honor all you have made and to care for the animals, plants, air, and bodies of water of this planet. God of grace, receive our prayer. We pray for those charged with leadership, lawmaking, and governance of our towns, states, and countries, that they will strive for goodness and justice all the days of their lives and callings. God of grace, receive our prayer. We pray for any who are sick and suffering, especially those in our own community. Vivian, Steve, Carol, Donna, Karen, Linda, Bud, Marilyn, Brecken, Jeanette, Christy, Betty, and those we say out loud and in our hearts. Guide us to offer hospitality, shelter, friendship, and care to any in need. God of grace, receive our prayer. We pray for this congregation and its ministry in the wider community. May we share the transforming beauty and love of God in ways that honor the dignity of all whom we encounter. God of grace, receive our prayer. Trusting that all the saints, prophets, and those who die in faith are held in your care, we remember in thanksgiving those who have died. Grant us your gift of salvation as we await your coming again in glory. God of grace, receive our prayer. Knowing the Holy Spirit intercedes for us, we offer these prayers and the silent prayers of our hearts in the name of our Savior, Jesus Christ. Amen. The peace of the Lord be with you always.
Let us pray. Blessed are you, Holy One, for all good things come from you. In bread and cup, you open heaven to us. Meet us at this table that we receive what we seek and follow your Son, Jesus, in whose name we pray. Amen.
The Lord be with you. Lift up your hearts. Let us give thanks to the Lord our God. It is indeed right, our duty and our joy, that we should at all times and in all places give thanks and praise to you, Almighty and merciful God, through our Savior Jesus Christ, who, sharing our life, lived among us to reveal your glory and love, that our darkness should give way to your own brilliant light. And so, with all the choirs of angels, with the church on earth and the hosts of heaven, we praise your name and join their unending hymn. Holy Lord, Lord God of power and might, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest.
Blessed are you, O holy God. You are the life and light of all. By your powerful word, you created all things. Through the prophets, you called your people to be a light to the nations. Blessed are you for Jesus, your Son. He is your light, shining in our darkness and revealing to us your mercy and might. In the night in which he was betrayed, our Lord Jesus took bread and gave thanks, broke it and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take and eat. This is my body given for you. Do this for the remembrance of me." Again, after supper, he took the cup, gave thanks, and gave it for all to drink, saying, "This cup is the new covenant in my blood, shed for you and for all people for the forgiveness of sin. Do this for the remembrance of me." Remembering, therefore, his preaching and healing, his dying and rising, and his promise to come again, we await that day when all the universe will rejoice in your holy and life-giving light. By your Spirit, bless us and this meal, that refreshed with this heavenly food, we may be light for the world, revealing the brilliance of your Son. Through him, all glory and honor is yours, Almighty Father, with the Holy Spirit, in your holy church, both now and forever. Amen. Gathered into one by the Holy Spirit, let us pray as Jesus taught us, as we sing together.
Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven.
At Jesus' table, heaven and earth are joined as one. Come and see. Let us pray. God, of giver of every gift, Christ's body is our food, and we are Christ's body. Raise us to life by your power for the benefit of all and to your glory. now and forever. Amen. And now, as we prepare to take communion to those who cannot be with us, let us pray. Gracious God, loving all your family with a mother's tender care, as you sent the angel to feed Elijah with heavenly bread, assist those who set forth to share your word and sacrament with those who are sick, homebound, and imprisoned. In your love and care, nourish and strengthen those who will receive this sacrament, and give us all the comfort of your abiding presence through the body and blood of your Son, Jesus Christ, our Lord. Amen. Christ who names you, God who names you, Christ who claims you, and the Holy Spirit who dwells in you, bless you and remain with you now and forever. Amen. I invite you to stand as you're able as we sing our closing hymn. It's 671 in your red hymnal.
And we'll start with the refrain.
We'll start with the refrain. Thank you. Go in peace. You are God's beloved. Thanks be to God.